final speaker of this panel will be Shion Kubota. She is a physics and computer science major here at Mount Holyoke, and she's going to talk about her experience working at CERN.
Why common sense can be common sense. So let's think about it. How much we know about this Earth? So we know about the mating system, rat, and addiction thing, and nanoparticle thing, which I'm not really familiar with. So we know pretty much about Earth. But how about outside of the Earth? Do we know a lot of a universe? But wait, do we actually really know everything in this Earth? Like, we don't know how we started. We don't know how the life started. So it turned out that we actually don't really know how the universe started, how we're here, like why we can be here. And that is one of the biggest questions that we are facing as a human being right now. And CERN is one of the organizations that are trying to explain how we can be here, how the life started. CERN is a European organization, like research organization, that does the biggest particle physics experiment in the world using this big machine. It's the yellow part is all machine. It is called a collider. It creates new particles, which we really can't see in nature because they are like so rare. And maybe some of you know, because I saw your faces in physics classes, but in 2012, they found Higgs boson, which is a new particle, aka God particle, because it was really important particle, but at the same time, goddamn particle, because it's so hard to find. But then they found it. So he actually brought CERN a Nobel Prize for it. So great. And also, but like Higgs boson, like you don't really know about it. If I'm not physics major, I wouldn't know about it. So Higgs boson isn't actually doing anything for our life. But CERN is actually doing something that we can utilize in our life too. For example, this thing on the right side, which is the cancer therapy machine that kills cancer through like using protons. And also WWW, World Wide Web, was also started at CERN. So CERN is also contributing to the world. And I got to work at CERN. I was so happy to let that picture. But I was working at CERN this summer, and I was doing research there by attending Malthusar Group, which is aiming to find a new particle by creating a new detector. So, some physicists know this movie, but Particle Fever, this is a really famous movie. It is a movie, a documentary about like how people found the Higgs boson in 2012, which I've already talked about. So since I saw this movie when I was first year, I've always dreamed of like going to CERN. It's like, for me, going to CERN was like, I don't know, being Jedi for Star Wars fan, or being like, I don't know, Marvel members for Avengers fan. So I was really excited, but I also had to face a lot of hardships, like walls. One of it was finding opportunity. So it was way back before I went to CERN, but okay, I'm here, Mom. But I couldn't find any particle physicist here. So I have to talk to Professor UMass, and that professor there has to talk to other university professor, and it continued like a chain until I found actually the professor at Stanford University, who actually can hire me to work for summer. So it was sometimes really hard because I was in liberal arts school, like I am in liberal arts school. But if you try to reach out outside of university, it actually works. So I didn't know that, but it actually works for me, so I'm really happy that it worked. And the second hardship was communicating with other members. So at CERN, I was like boss baby. I was not sure that I was born later, but I was the youngest of that team. All the other members were professors, including two professors who were older than 75 years old, and most of the other students were grad school students or PhD students. And I was the only one under grad students. So I found it really difficult to communicate with grad students because I was in charge of giving order or giving tasks to them. So I have to be really polite and I have to like really try to collaborate with them. Like I'd be always thinking that like being physicist like in one room with paper, pencil, and I just work for physics, but not actually like that. I didn't know physicists how to collaborate with it, but I really could learn how to collaborate with physics people this time. And other stuff, life outside of CERN. So as I said, CERN is on the border of Switzerland and France, and then I was living in that yellow CERN place. So I actually was living in France area, which means I have to speak in French, but okay, way back when I came here, I was from Japan. I was born in Japan and raised up for in Japan for 18 years. And when I came here, it was my first experience to have to like use English in daily life. So it was really hard for me. But because I knew some English words, I actually could communicate with people. But I was happy. However, in France, the only word that I knew French was bonjour. So I have to keep on saying like bonjour, 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 like happy. It was really hard, and I was so ashamed of myself sometimes. But being inside of CERN, it was great because in CERN we're using scientific language and it was mainly in English. So as our title say, science is actually international language. When I'm learning science, I actually can communicate with all the people around the world, which is fantastic for me. So going into CERN, it was my dream. I made my dream come true. My new dream is going back to CERN again to do research. Through hardships, I learned a lot of things, like how to communicate with people, actually what science, what being science would be like. Like I have to like collaborate with people, I have to talk politely, I have to still think it is important to talk in person. It was actually a new realization for me because it was my first time outside of Mount Hoyo and I didn't know what is it about like being outside of the bubble Mount Hoyo. So at the end of my presentation, I was just want to say, I didn't know I can choose being with LEAP and imposter session. So I did both, it was crazy. My week was crazy this week, and I'm devoting most of my time to imposter session too. So please come, Tuesday afternoon, 15:30, Canada over there. And I know some of my business friends are doing imposter session too, so please, please, please come. So that you can change most of your unknowns into knowns. Thank you.